Then I said, where are the widows? And three women came to the front. Who believes in miracles? All of you. Praise the Lord. One time in Congo, in Lubumbashi, I was there, and a prophet came and he said to me, Apostle, your vehicle is on the way. Now you can think what you want. I was driving in these days into Africa with the 1100 Uno Fiat. I was sleeping in it. I was driving with it and carrying stuff with me. And now I come back to South Africa, and in these days the Tata Buckies came out, 99,000 rand. And I said, let me get a quotation. And I put it in my pocket. And we come to a home cell. And in the home cell, there was a businessman. And he said, with what car are you going into Africa? I said, no, with my green Uno 1100. He said, no, you can't go with that. I buy you a Bucky. Get me a quotation. I said, wait. That is what I said this morning, faith in action. Ne? And I took out and I gave him the quotation, just now there. And then he said to me, come tomorrow to my office. I called the agent to come. And the next morning he's phoning me and said, don't come to my office anymore. I said, no, it's all right. So I thought, he might have changed his mind. He said, no, I'm already with the agent. What you like? Aircon, radio? I said, no, full house. And when you make the full house, add also a tow bar. And 1 week later, I received the Bucky. And when they fixed the tow bar, next door was a canopy place. So I went there and I said, give me a quotation for the canopy. And I put it in my bag. And then another businessman came and said, you for sure you need a canopy now. Get me a quotation. I said, I got already one here. He said, come to my office tomorrow morning and get the check. So I went the next morning, he said 7 o'clock, and 7 o'clock for me, as a German, time is time. If I say I will be there 8 o'clock, I will be there 8 o'clock. Not 8:05, but 8:05. And when I came there, he was not there. So I phoned him, I said, where are you? I'm waiting here for you. He said, oh, I never thought you would be so in time. I said, no, I'm a time conscious man. And that is what we all have to learn, to be time conscious. There's a saying, time is money, or, ne? And also in the kingdom of God, time is value. If a pastor says to me, and if a pastor tells you from a residing church, I give you 20 minutes, you stick to this 20 minutes. You do not force your 30 minutes, because then you don't respect him. And you respect also the people's time. It's important. I tell you, one time in Congo, in Mwanda, and the coast of the Atlantic. I was preaching and all of a sudden, I never took offerings. I said, I want to take an offering. Behind me sitting 15 pastors. And nobody wants to bring to me the baskets for the offering. So I went down and I saw them in the back of the church. So I went there, picked them up, and went to the front and said to the people, come, bring your offerings. And everybody was looking. The pastors were wondering, what is this guy doing now? In the middle of the service, taking up an offering. Now, the money is coming. I called one of the ladies, or two of the ladies who were sitting in the front. I said, count the money. While I was standing there, said, counting. And I turned around to the pastors. I said, you may look at it, but you may not touch it. And after they counted it, they said it was 36,000 francs silver. Then I said, where are the widows? And three women came to the front. And so we divided the money, 36 by 3 is 12, ne? So each one received 12. The first woman counted, put it in her pocket. The second woman, she counted, and she counted again, and put from this 12,000, 5,000 back into the offering. The third woman just kept it in her hand, and she started crying. Then the pastor said, may I interrupt? I said, you're welcome. And he said, people, I must confess. This woman lost her husband last week, and she came and asked me for help, and I refused her. But God has heard her cry. You see, it's not only touched me, but it taught a big lesson to all the pastors. So look after the widows. It's a law of Moses, Deuteronomy 28. If you do that, you receive the blessing of God. Look after the orphans. Look after the poor. Sometimes we see in South Africa almost every robot someone standing with a board. Ne? Some of them are fake. Some of them are already rich. Some of them are real poor people. We cannot help everybody, but let gets led by the Spirit of God. So that the Spirit of God is giving us wisdom and understanding. Where do we get wisdom from? From the Word of God. If you want wisdom, start reading the Proverbs. If you want to learn how to pray, read the Psalms. Like this short chorus, Holy Spirit, it's a prayer. It's a prayer. And when we pray according to the Scripture, nothing can go wrong.